For your connections with the SUPERCELL, there are a few different options depending on what you're trying to achieve. Anytime you use a blast gate for, you know, almost any purpose, you need to have an adapter to it to make sure it can connect to your ductwork. So if we're going over this blast gate adapter, you want, you know, a smooth opening there, go over, nice tight fit. If you're going over another crimped fitting, like a Y or a piece of ductwork or a pipe, you're gonna want what we call a no crimped blast gate adapter. That will allow the correct fit. If you're going from your blast gate adapter into a piece of flex hose, you're going to want our blast gate adapter that is crimped. That way, the blast gate adapter is able to go inside the hose. Connecting from the flex hose to the machine here, I'll actually need one of each. On this side, I'll need the crimped end because it's gonna go inside my flex hose. And on the other end, I'll want the non-crimped adapter so I can go over the end of the machine. And then I'll go ahead and screw these all together. For when we are ducting a SUPERCELL using flex hose, we have a unique Y that we make for this purpose. And what's unique about it is that it's crimped on all three ends. This allows us to insert flex hose over each end without needing any extra pieces or components. Insert that, tighten down our clamp, and then take the other end, insert that, and tighten down that clamp. And there you go. We've made a connection of a Y splitter to two pieces of flex hose. And so then if we needed or wanted a blast gate, on this end of the Y, what we would need to do is we need to use blast gate adapter no crimp, which we would insert over the crimped end to increase the diameter, and then our blast gate is able to insert right inside there. And then we would make the connection with sheet metal screws, and then if we're going to flex hose out of the blast gate, we would use the blast gate adapter that is crimped on one side. That would allow us to take the flex hose and insert it right over, like that. If you were connecting this blast gate right to a machine, you would end up using blast gate adapter with no crimps so that it maintained the diameter here to attach directly to the machine port. Now we will show you sealing your ductwork. It is important to seal your ductwork to make sure that you maintain as much airflow to your tools as possible. Having the air go through the joints reduces the air that ultimately will come through your tool. So to do that, there are a couple different approaches. You can use metal duct tape like here, and you can use a silicone or a caulk that we have here and you probably have around your shop. So I'll go ahead and show you how to do those. So in this case, we have our Y, and I want to attach a blast gate at this end of the Y before I go onto my tool. And so we're going to use the no crimped blast gate adapter. I'm gonna put that on. I'm gonna put in two sheet metal screws. And once it's secured, you're gonna take your aluminum tape, and it doesn't have to be exact. You wanna make sure you get around at least once. Tear a piece off. I just like to get in the middle of the joint, get one side down, the other side down. And go around and get a little crinkly, but you just press it all in, make sure it's tight all the way around so it doesn't leak. It doesn't have to look pretty, it just needs to be effective. And that seam is airtight, and on seams where you can get a piece of tape around like that, that's a great fast way to make sure your ducting is airtight. For options where you can't get a piece of tape around, or you just have a preference of using a sealant, we'll show that now. In this case, it's faster to put your sealant on first. So So we're going to go all the way around, weaving a nice little bead. And we're going to take our blast gate, we're going to slip it in, push it up into that sealant. Again, then we're going to sheet metal screw it. And I want it tilted just like that. Put my second screw in the other side. Go. Once that's in, so we're going to go ahead and just use our finger to spread it around. Make sure we got an airtight seal. Again, doesn't have to be perfect and pretty. Just needs to be effective. I'll do this side too. And now that joint, once it cures, will be airtight and we'll have no leakage. So that seals these two joints here on the blast gate and between the adapter and the Y. For your flex hose side, the flex hose and the hose clamp being nice and tight provides that seal. So I don't need to do additional sealant on joints with flex hose, so long as my clamp is nice and tight.